Hey, brothers and sisters, this is Brother Patrick. I'm still out here near Area 51. I haven't seen any aliens by the grace of God. You know, as I just made a video earlier today, or yesterday when this is posted, that, of course, the aliens are the fallen angels, or demons. Demons, probably more precisely, than fallen angels. Brothers and sisters, I wanted to try to talk about or pray for those who ask for prayer requests. And I've got some new names. My internet load, I have this hot spot, and my load has expired just tonight. So I can't go on there. There's a few more people who had asked me to pray, and I didn't have it written it on my list. But after I do this one, by the grace of God, I'll be kind of be caught up here. Some of you guys I've already given words to partially. And wanted more explanation. I just wrote your name in here, and I didn't put what you're looking for, because I just want to be it by the Spirit of God, not by my own ideas. So I asked all of you guys who are watching this, you will pray in agreement. God is outside time and seasons, and God will, you know, add your prayer to mine, even if you prayed next week, if you saw this. Because God is beyond time and space and location. So let's all pray in agreement for the people on this list. Now, the first name is Terry. Terry, let's pray for Terry. Father, right now, in the name of Jesus Christ, the Son of the living God, we pray for Sister Terry. I believe it's a sister. It is a sister. Thank you, Lord. This is a Sister Terry. As a matter of fact, from Canada. Father, right now, in the name of Jesus, I just declare victory. Victory over death, hell, and the grave. Victory over death, hell, and the grave. Right now, I just say that no weapon formed against you shall prosper. Every tongue that rises up against you, thou shalt condemn. This is the inheritance of the saints of God, and their righteousness is of me, saith the Lord. That's Isaiah 55:17 for Sister Terry in Canada. The Lord has given you the victory over death, hell, and the grave, and that every tongue that rises up against you, thou shalt condemn. This is the inheritance of the saints of God, and their righteousness is of me, says the Lord. Every weapon formed against, no weapon formed against you shall prosper. That's the word of the Lord for Sister Terry. You know, the Lord is with you, Sister Terry. I ask you guys to pray for Sister Terry. She's got the victory. God's going to make a way for her in all things. Abner. I'm not taking notes. You know, I'm just marking off the names as I say them. Abner. Abner. Let's all pray for Abner. Father, in the name of Jesus Christ, the Son of the living God, we declare right now victory for Brother Abner. And I just keep hearing this thing, Little Shop of Horrors. You know, that's a movie, a comedy movie, but about horror. And I saw that. I was a kid when I saw that movie, Little Shop of Horrors. And I think that was a remake of an old one from the 1950s. I think it's some kind of a play, as a matter of fact, a Broadway play. So the original Little Shop of Horrors is somehow related to you, Abner, in the name of Jesus. And we just pray for your victory over that little house of horrors. And we pray for the Lord to give you the blessing and deliverance and freedom. Maybe you're in your house. Maybe you're surrounded by unsaved people or whatever. Something like that. I don't know. But we pray that you'll be delivered and have victory over the little house of horrors. And just pray, seek the Lord, trust the Lord. God will make a way for you, Brother Abner. Lindsay, I just remember our name. I need to add to this. And I don't know if I got them all. I may have already got these names, but they just came to mind right now. The Lord just dumped it on me, all the names I need to pray for, I think. Lindsay, right now, Father, in the name of Jesus, we declare victory for Sister Lindsay right now, Lord. And Lord, we just ask you, Lord, just to pour out the victory right now in Jesus' name. Hallelujah, Lord God. We give you the praise. Lord, we give you the glory. We give you the honor. Hallelujah, in Jesus' name. Lord, for Lindsay, Lord, I just declare victory right now. And I see someone with red hair. And I don't know exactly what that means. But I see someone with red hair, which is something, you know, unrelated. I hear red hair, actually. In relation to Lindsay right now, in the name of Jesus, Father, we give you the praise. We give you the glory. We give you the honor right now, Lord God. And I just hear the Lord saying, seek and ye shall find. Seek and ye shall find. Lindsay, seek and ye shall find. Sometimes the red-headed thing could be, A, you have red hair, or B, red is symbolic. Red hair, you know, red is symbolic of, you know, fire, like fire of the Holy Spirit. It could be fire of judgment, fire of the Holy Spirit. But the focus, though, is seeking ye shall find Lindsay. Okay, right now, next is Sheila. Sheila, and I think I wrote down. Sheila just asked me the other day something specific. Yes. And just yesterday or today, I got a message from Sheila with specifics. Like I say, there's some people that give me specific information. I don't even read it because I don't want it to taint. You know, people are asking this specifically about something. For one thing, God doesn't always answer the question that you want to ask. God gives you what you need to hear, not what you think you need to hear. And then secondly, I don't want it to taint what I may hear from the Lord. So I usually don't read it. But it was a little short thing that Sheila had written to me about to pray about. And let's just pray. Father, right now in the name of Jesus Christ, the Son of the living God. Father, we just thank you right now. I just declare victory right now for Sister Sheila. Lord, I ask, Lord, for her prayer request about this house to do with her mom and the house. Father, we just pray right now in the name of Jesus Christ, Lord, that your will be done. Let your kingdom come. Let your will be done in Sheila as it is in heaven, Lord God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, Father. We give you the praise and the glory right now, Father, in Jesus' name. Hallelujah, Lord. We give you the praise and glory in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. And I just keep, the Lord is showing me and saying that his will be done. To do his will. What is his will? And I guess the Lord has already told you. I don't think you mentioned in the note to me. But God's, you know, the Lord keeps showing me about his will. Let his will be done. And I don't know what that is, sister. He didn't tell me that. He just keeps telling me that thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. And then I keep seeing a will, a literal will. A will going round and round. So sometimes the Lord shows you in different ways. I heard it and then I saw it to confirm the Lord's will be done. Let the Lord's will be done, or his will be done. Sister Sheila, if I had any more from the Lord, I would tell you. That's, as someone wrote on my video, you know, it's a word from the Lord. Not all the details, but a word. And it's as much or as little as the Lord wants to give. All right. T-I-R-A-N-I. I guess that's tyranny. Tyranny? Tyranny? Not tyranny. Tyranny. Father, right now, I just pray for, I guess that's Sister Tarani. Father, right now, in the name of Jesus Christ, the Son of the living God, I ask for your blessings. We come in agreement, Lord, for Tarani, right now, in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah, Father, we praise you. We thank you. We honor you, Father, in the name of Jesus. And I just see glory. I see the glory of God. I see the golden, like the gold dust glory of God. I see the gold dust glory of God in reference to you. I believe that's a sister to Rani. In Jesus' name, I see gold dust, like, you know, the glory of God manifested as like a golden cloud. Okay, Brian. I guess that's Brian M. Brian M. Father, right now, in the name of Jesus, Father, we give you the praise and the glory. Hallelujah. You know, there's another Brian and brother. His last initial is also an M. But this is someone who specifically gave me their name, Brian M. And it's a different YouTube channel than OT4Jesus. Because I'm getting confused. I'm getting different people's YouTube channels mixed up. Anyway, this is a Brian M. who I've never messaged with before. I don't know you. There's another brother I know that's named Brian. And it's not. I'm getting all my YouTube channels messed up here. This is a different Brian M. if it's not you. Anyway, Father, right now in the name of Jesus Christ, Lord, we just pray your blessings on this brother, Brian M., in Jesus' name. And I hear the Lord just showing me that a head. And so you are the head and not the tail. You need to be the head of your family and be in lead and control, or, you know, in authority in your situation. Now, I don't know all your situation. Maybe I don't know if you're married or what. Maybe your wife is trying to be an authority, or, you know, you're not walking in the authority you have over your wife or your children, your family. God just showed me that, you know, you need to be the head. and not let somebody else be the head. You need to be the leader and the head and leader and guider of your family, of your wife, children, whatever, or all the above. Brother Brian M. All right. Now there's Sarah. Father, right now in the name of Jesus, we come in agreement and pray for Sister Sarah right now. Rejoice in the Lord always. And again, I say rejoice. It's a Bible verse. It's also a song. I'm trying to think who sings it. Israel Houghton sings a version of it. But there's a Bible verse. Rejoice in the Lord always. And again, I say rejoice. That's the word of the Lord for you, Sister Sarah. All right. Thank you, Lord. Sometimes, you know, once I can start flowing in it by the Spirit of God, sometimes it's, you know, fast. You know, sometimes I have to start out by faith and then it begins to move. There's a brother from Dallas, Brother Darren from Dallas, who's going to be on the website. Hey, the website's up. I think I mentioned this the other day. If you watch this, the Church the Firstborn, the website's below every video. We have the prayer thing going. You can submit a prayer request. And then we have different categories and different things for counseling too. As an example, Brother Darren in Dallas is doing the ministry of counseling new Christians. You're not necessarily talking evangelism, but you're talking about a new convert and helping them get on the right track as a new Christian. So it's a new convert section of the website. Anyway, and Brother Darren and I were talking today, and he was telling me he found one of my old videos. I should put the link below here too. And he was just showing how that I started out the video, and almost all my videos are like that. And he was observing that as a objective observer, that I started out, you know, in my videos just talking normally, and then as the Spirit would fill me more and more and more, I would begin to preach more and more under the power of the anointing. And the same thing with these words. Even though I'm being calm because I'm trying to hear from the Lord to get a word for individuals, every time I give a word for another individual, it's like preaching a brand new sermon. You know, when you start in preaching, you start flowing with it and going, but you're following on message. I'm given like a message, even though it's only a few words or one Bible verse or something. This is like preaching 20 sermons, boom, 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 because I had to get something new and fresh for each person from the Lord, from the manna of the Lord, you know, the bread of heaven to fall into my spirit, and I can give it out. It's just like, even though it's short, it's just, that's the same process you go through to receive a message, a preaching sermon that might be 40 minutes long. But this is only 1 minute long, but it's still the same process. I have to empty out, like the Lord gave me a word for Sarah about, rejoice in the Lord always. And again, I say rejoice. I have to get that out of my spirit and then empty my spirit out and start anew for each person. So that's why I have to remain calm. I can't, you know, if I start running with it, then I will never get to any other people. So, you already did, Brian. Joe N. Did I already say something? let's just pray. I'm going to pray again for Joe N. In the name of Jesus. Father, in the name of Jesus Christ, the Son of the living God, we pray for Joe N. Right now, Father, in the name of Jesus Christ, Lord. And the Lord is just speaking to me the word selective, like selective service. Now, selective service is about registering for the draft. And the Lord is just talking to me about the word selective service for you, Joe N. I don't know what that means. Maybe you need to make a selection. Somebody's going to select you. Brother, that's the word from the Lord for you, selective service, in Jesus' name. Sister Rebecca. Let's pray for Sister Rebecca. Father, in the name of Jesus Christ, the Son of the living God, we exalt your holy name in this place, and we lift up Sister Rebecca to you. Lord, we lift her up to you, Lord God. And we just praise your name, Lord, and we ask you to bless her, Father, in Jesus' name. We ask you to bless her, Father, in Jesus' name. And right now I just see that that you're surrounded. I see that you're surrounded. And I'm just trying to see. I can just see that you're surrounded, but I don't know what it is. The Lord is not showing it to me. Are enough for me to understand it. Father, right now, I just ask for your guidance, your wisdom, Lord God, because I just hear shroud, like the shroud of Turin. It's you're shrouded in this thing, but I saw something that looked like Stonehenge, and of course, the Stonehenge is new age, you know, it's old age, but new age, Druidism. I see shrouded in mystery, or like the shroud of Turin about you. So there's some shrouded mystery there, and I don't know what it is, sister. The Lord is not revealing it to me. But Sister Rebecca, I just pray right now in Jesus' name the victory for you, that whatever it is will be unshrouded. Whatever is this mystery, and the Lord is not revealing it to me. Maybe because I'm tired, and maybe because He don't want me to reveal it. The Lord is like that. He doesn't reveal everybody's secrets. There could be someone on this list who's secretly, you know, homosexual. The Lord's not, might not necessarily tell me, oh, this person's homosexual. He may tell me, and I would private message you, hey, the Lord is saying that you need to repent of homosexuality. Not to, you know, make a public show of you, because he doesn't want to do that to you. Sometimes He does. He tries to get people to repent. They won't repent. Then He begins to kick it up a notch, you know, like bam, to get you to repent. So, and I'm not saying that about you, Sister Rebecca. I don't know. I do not know. But it's shrouded, sister. And I want to ask people to continue to pray for Sister Rebecca, that that whatever it is will be revealed, and, you know, whatever needs to be done will be done. If she needs to repent, I have no idea, sister. I don't know. Or what's going on around you. Just, we're praying for you, Father. In Jesus' name, we're praying for Sister Rebecca to lift her up. And that's why, you know, I said we lift up the Lord's name, because the Lord was giving me that word to lift up. So to lift you up. And I believe that's, you know, what the Lord told me in the beginning. And I was already saying about lifting the Lord's name up, so I didn't want to, you know. I was thinking, you know, I want to make sure that's wasn't in my spirit. And I saw this Stonehenge, and then I heard like shroud or shrouded, like the shroud of Turin. And so, I, you know, the Lord wants us to lift you up. And I ask people to put Sister Rebecca on your prayer list, and let's lift her up in Jesus' name. We're praying for you. You got the victory through the blood of Jesus. Don't let anything, you know, the Spirit of the Lord, where the Spirit of the Lord is, there is liberty. And, you know, the Lord will not let you be bound. And we pray that you're not bound. We pray for you to be free in Jesus' name. And there's people who's going to watch this, 200 or 300 people. And out of that, let's just say 100 people is going to pray for you at least, Sister Rebecca. Remember that. All right, or around you. Could be your family members. Okay, Penny with an I. Father, right now in the name of Jesus, we pray for Sister Penny, and we give you the praise and glory, Father, in Jesus' name, Lord. Hallelujah, Father. We praise you, Father. We praise you, Father, in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Father, we just praise your holy name for Sister Penny, Lord. We thank you for her sacrifices. We thank you for her giftings, Lord God. We thank you for I just hear the word Rubicon. Now the Rubicon, you know, the Lord's giving me, sometimes he'll give me a Bible verse, sometimes something's, it's out there. Now there's, you know, the famous thing, there's even a Shakespeare play about Caesar upon the Rubicon, you know, about crossing a Rubicon. Now the whole metaphor of that is it's like there's a big wall and a big challenge in your life, and it's something that's been blocking you, and when you cross that Rubicon, it's like a new beginning. You know, you have that breakthrough, just like, you know, George Washington, like myself, when I was breaking forward in the ministry through a bunch of barriers, the Lord kept showing me that George Washington crossing the Delaware River. You know, and it's like, the Lord showed me, as a matter of fact, I think it was 2012, the Lord showed me that all year 2012, I believe it was, maybe it was 2011. And, you know, as I prayed about it, meditated on it, it's like, you know, the Revolutionary Army was defeated. You know, this is just like Caesar crossing the Rubicon that I saw for you. It looked like everything was defeated, and the American Revolutionary Army had been, you know, beat down and all this. They had stayed at Valley Forge, all that stuff. And then on Christmas Day, you know, out of the nowhere, President Washington took this, or at that time General Washington took this surprise attack, and just suddenly, you know, took his forces there on Christmas, and they showed up there at Trenton, New Jersey, and caught the Hessian German soldiers drunk. And you know, had a great defeat that ultimately led to the victory for the American Revolution. Turned the tide and the morale and everything. And so Caesar crossing the Rubicon is the same thing. You know, it turned, you know, Rome into the empire that they became. Now, lots of times people in their shallow-mindedness, they only think Rome, they think evil, they think all that stuff. But God can use those things also as an example of something good. So... just like, you know, with George Washington, the same thing with Caesar crossing the Rubicon. You know, there's something that you've been hesitating to go for, like David and Goliath, you know. It's like David defeating Goliath is what made David famous. Even though he was already called to be the king, he was already anointed to be the king, but nobody knew who he was. He was just a shepherd boy. And then when he came, defeated Goliath, boom, that's what made him famous. Everybody knows David defeated Goliath, and that's what made him the famous man that really, in the world, he became known as the little young teenager who defeated the giant, became the king of Israel. Even today, everybody, little children know about David defeating Goliath. They don't necessarily even know he was a king, but they know he defeated Goliath. Same thing is true with George Washington, because he was the general that won the Revolutionary War. And the turning point was when he crossed the Delaware. Same thing with Caesar. What made Caesar great and expanded the Roman Empire and all that, became the control of the whole world, was when he decided to cross the Rubicon. So I've been through all this history lesson, but that's for you, Sister Penny. So you're facing your Rubicon. You're facing your giant. And God has already given you the victory and already told you you got the victory, and you've just been hesitating. It's time to go for it. Do it now. In Jesus' name, go with God's speed and do it in Jesus' name. That's a short version. Nicholas, Father, in the name of Jesus Christ, we pray for Brother Nicholas right now, Lord. And I declare, I get the word defeated. I get the word defeated from the Lord. Defeated. That's the word I hear from the Lord for Nicholas. Defeated. Now, you have been defeated, or you think you're defeated, or you're defeated. But it's by faith. All things from God come through faith, Nicholas. God can turn things around, Brother Nicholas. And you've been defeated, and you think you're defeated and all that, but God's mercies are new every morning. Great is His faithfulness, like that song. It's a Bible verse too. His mercies are new every morning. Great is Thy faithfulness, O Lord. Great is Thy faithfulness. The steadfast love of the Lord never ceases. His mercies never come to an end. They're new every morning. Great is Thy faithfulness. The Lord is faithful, and to whom He's called, and God will pick you up. Turn to the Lord. Seek Him, and He's going to turn it all around by His grace. He's a process. God puts us through a process to become what He wants us to be, like Joseph. He was told, he had the dreams, everybody, his brother's going to bow down to him, his parents was going to bow down to him. Then he was sold into slavery, and then he was falsely accused of rape, thrown into prison, but yet later on, he rose to the position that the Lord had showed him from the beginning. So Nicholas, even though you've been defeated, God's not finished with you. But you don't be finished with God. Get back in the ring. Get back in the ring. Get back in the game. God's got the victory for you in Jesus' name. Marianne. Father, right now I pray for Sister Marianne. Father, right now in the name of Jesus Christ, the Son of the living God, we pray for Sister Marianne. I hear like violins. I hear the word violins, music, sweet sound. Let it be a sweet, sweet song. Let it be a sweet, sweet sound in your ears. Take joy, my Lord, Lord, for what you hear. That's what I hear for you, Sister Marianne. Let it be a sweet, sweet sound in your ears. That's the song I hear for you in my spirit from the Lord for you, Sister Marianne. Sister Tanya, Father, right now in the name of the Most High God, I declare, Lord, victory. We declare victory for Sister Tanya right now. Over all the forces of darkness, over death, hell, and the grave, over the world, the flesh, and the devil, right now we declare victory for Sister Tanya. Right now, hallelujah. Father, we give you the praise and glory in Jesus' name, Lord. I just see this whirlwind. I see a whirlwind, Sister Tanya. But I also see liberty. Where the Spirit of the Lord is, there's liberty. You're surrounded by a whirlwind. But where the Spirit of the Lord is, there's liberty. And you've got liberty in Christ Jesus. Don't let those people keep you down. Don't let those people down. Let those people keep you down. That's from the Lord in Jesus' name. Millie, right now, Father, in the name of Jesus, we pray for Sister Millie. Father, we just exalt your holy name. We exalt your holy name, Father, in the name of Jesus. And hallelujah, Lord, I just see this, I guess that's Father, we give you the praise and glory for Sister Millie. Lord, we thank you for her. Lord, we thank you for her spirit. We thank you for her being part of the body of Christ. And I just see you, you know, you as righteous. I see you as washed. You know, in Isaiah chapter 1, it says, you know, come now, let us reason together. Though your sins be as scarlet, they'll be white as snow. And what I've been seeing, I was just waiting on the Lord for more detail, is that, you know, this white righteousness, that your skin is white, you're washed white, your spirit is white, washed white by the blood of the Lamb. And that's what the Lord wants me to tell you, that, you know, I see you as wearing the righteousness of Christ, that you're you know, white as snow. Your sin has been forgiven you. Sorry, I'm tired. I'm not articulating my words properly, but you're white as snow. You're redeemed. You're cleansed by the blood of the Lamb, Sister Millie. Your sins are scarlet, but they've been washed by the blood of the Lamb. You're white as snow in the eyes of the Lord by His blood. Sister Jessica, Father, right now in the name of Jesus Christ, the Son of the living God, Father, we just praise you for Sister Jessica. Lord, we know, Lord, that you are the God on high. I keep hearing from the Lord that it comes from on high. That it comes from on high. The Lord is giving you something, like blessings or whatever it is. Blessings is something good. All good things come from above, the Bible says. The Lord wants you to know that what you received is from on high. It's from Him. Whatever you've received, some recent blessing, whatever, it's from on high. It's from the Lord. Sister Jessica. Hallelujah, Father. We praise you, Lord. We just pray for Sister Deb. Right now, I got the name Deb. We pray for Sister Deb in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, Father. Hallelujah. I just hear the word about sanctuary. Praise His name in the sanctuary, Deb. Praise His name in the sanctuary. And the name of the Lord is a strong tower. The righteous run into Him and they are saved. The Lord is your sanctuary. That's what the Lord is telling me. You know, the name of the Lord, that's Bible verses. The name of the Lord is a strong tower. The righteous run into Him and they are saved. It's the word of the Lord for you, Sister Deb. Sister Jean, J-E-A-N. Jean, Father, right now in the name of Jesus Christ, we just speak your grace, your mercy, your blessings upon Sister Jean right now, Lord God. Hallelujah. Lord, we just declared a victory right now. Hallelujah. 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 And Lord, is just, I heard ghost. I don't think it's Holy Ghost. I heard ghost. Sister Jean, you got the victory. A ghost is nothing but a demon. If that's what you're dealing with, you just take authority over right now in Jesus' name. Now, maybe I misunderstood the Lord in that because I'm tired. Maybe He's talking about you being baptized in the Holy Spirit. Because as you know, I began to speak in an unknown tongue, in a prayer language. It's called building up your most holy faith, praying in the Spirit. As I just did, maybe that's what the Lord was talking about. But I just heard the word ghost. Not Holy Ghost, but ghost. So pray for you right now. Deliverance over these some kind of demonic thing. Plead the blood of Jesus. There's power in the name of Jesus. There's power in the blood of Jesus. Proclaim. Plead the blood over your house. Go through. We all come in agreement. I ask people to pray for Sister Jean about this. Just lift her up. And we declare victory right now that all things are under the feet of Jesus. He gave us the power to walk over the scorpions and the snakes. And Jesus was not talking to necessarily just literal snakes and serpents and all that stuff. He's talking about demons. We have authority over all the power of the enemy, the Bible said. Jesus said too. Okay, Anne. Sister Anne. Father, right now in the name of Jesus Christ, the Son of the living God, Lord, we just pray for Sister Anne. Lord, we just thank you for Sister Anne. Father, hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. I just see the Lord's arm and He's carrying a towel over His arm. And it reminds me of like the Lord washing people's feet and being a servant and washing people's feet. That's what I see when I started praying for you, Sister Anne. This servant, spirit of a servant, servanthood. And servitude. So, you know, you have the spirit of a servant, or the Lord wants you to have the spirit of a servant, or you do have the spirit of a servant. Sometimes I get real specific, sister. But, you know, I can only say what the Lord showed me. He showed me, you know, that servanthood, like washing people's feet. And either you have it, or he just wants you to have it. But, and I'm sorry, sister, I can't tell you specifically about that. Sister Ann. Ask everybody to pray for her, too. We pray, Lord, for clarity in the mind and the heart of Sister Ann in Jesus' name. Now I've got Lindak, L-I-N-D-A-K. Lindak. I think that's, I can't even hardly read my own handwriting, brothers and sisters. All right, Father, right now in the name of Jesus, we pray for Sister Lindak. Speak that the salvation of the Lord is yours. The salvation of the Lord is yours. Father, we thank you right now in Jesus' name. Father, we thank you right now in Jesus' name. Father, we thank you right now in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. For the word of the Lord is your strength, Lindak. The word of the Lord is your strength. Louise K. from England. Louise K. from England. Father, right now in the name of Jesus Christ for Louise, Lord God, we just pray right now. Hallelujah. 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 The wrath of God is stored up for the wicked, and the wealth of the wicked is stored up for the righteous. That's what the Lord wants me to tell you, Sister Louise, in the name of Louise K, in Jesus' name. The wrath of God is stored up for the wicked, and the wealth of the wicked is stored up for the righteous. Well, let's just pray for Sister Louise. I ask you guys to come and agree with me and pray for Sister Louise and her husband, Andrew. Let's just pray for them right now in Jesus' name, Lord, for the victory, Lord, for the victory right now. And the Lord has just given me Psalm 61, Brother Andrew, to read that. And it says in there, besides the fact that in the beginning it says, the Spirit of the Lord is upon me. The Lord read that, and the Spirit of that is also on his people. The Lord said that the Spirit of the Lord is upon me to set the captives free, preach liberty to those who are bound. And on down there it says to give, you know, the joy, you know, the oil of joy for the garment and for sadness, and the garment of praise, and all that. In other words, God would, I'm getting mixed up quoting it because it's written from the Greek in the New Testament, and then from the Old Testament it's from the Hebrew. Luke chapter 4 is part of that. And then 4:18, Jesus quotes from that. But the original text, Isaiah 61, starting at verse 1, Brother Andrew and Sister Louise, read that. And the Lord will give you the garment of praise for the spirit of heaviness. That's what I'm trying to tell you that I heard from the Lord. The Lord's going to give you the garment of praise. And then the word I gave for Sister Louise, I already repeated it twice. But for Brother Andrew, the Lord's going to give you the garment of praise for the spirit of heaviness. Know that the Lord is with you. You've got to praise the Lord, Brother Andrew. You've got to praise the Lord. Where the Spirit of the Lord is, there is liberty. The Spirit of the Lord inhabits the praises of his people. You have got to praise his name. You've got to lift up his name, Brother Andrew. You just got to do it. And God's going to give you the garment of praise and take away the spirit of heaviness in Jesus' name. I'm still going, brothers and sisters. I'm over 30 minutes. I don't know how far I can go. Sister Nicole, I probably should stop because I'm tired, brothers and sisters, but let me try. Right now, Father, in the name of Jesus Christ, we just pray for Sister Nicole. And I hear the word advance. Advanced or advance. Like you would get a financial advance or you would advance in your job. The Lord is going to advance you. So you will be advanced or you will receive an advance is the word. I hear just one word, advanced or advance. To advance or to get an advance in your job, I would assume, sister. Or in the kingdom of God, the Lord is advancing you or he will advance you, Sister Nicole, right now in Jesus' name. We come in agreement right now. Yes, just Father, we give you the praise and glory in Jesus' name. I ask you, brothers and sisters, to pray in agreement with me. You know, I praise the Lord. No one is really, people have received the videos that the Lord gave me to give, giving words to people. You know, one person, there's this one specific person, I don't want to say their name, that that's always used by the enemy, you know, that comes as like a friend, like Judas, you know, someone that comes to you as a friend, but actually their job is to try to tear you down and cause you to have doubt and unbelief. There's one person that does that to me since I started my YouTube channel, really. And I just ask you to pray for this unnamed person, because their suggestive doubt and unbelief just plays in the back of my mind, just why I've been trying to make this video. And I know how the enemy operates. I've been dealing with him for 14 years at high levels. And I know all of, as Paul said, we're not ignorant of his devices. And I know that this person's all about. And I ask you just to pray for this person, that they will repent of this, smile in your face and stab you in the back attitude at what they do to cause doubt and unbelief. And, you know, just being honest with you. Maybe you guys experience that too. Yeah, people do that. A wolf in sheep's clothing. People will try to be your friend. But you can't go by what you see in the flesh. You know, we can go by people's words, you know, the fruit they bear. And so when someone's causing you doubt and unbelief about God or the things of God, then of course that's not from the Lord. The Lord doesn't cause us to have doubt and unbelief about Him or the things that He's called us to do. You know, they use a backwards way to sneak to try to tear you down and make you look bad and make you feel bad and knock you down, but they do it in a sneaky way. There's some high-level people and deceptive spirits that do these kind of things. And I ask you to pray for this unnamed person, that they will see that, what they're doing, they'll repent of that, that they'll overcome that in Jesus' name. Let's pray for Sister Charlene. Right now, Father, in the name of Jesus Christ, the Son of the living God, we pray for Sister Charlene, Lord God. We pray for her victory right now. We pray for your wisdom to be upon her, Lord God. Hallelujah, hallelujah, Father, we give you the praise and the glory. Hallelujah, hallelujah, Father, we give you the praise and the glory. And I just see that a ministry for you, Sister Charlene, led by the Lord, a ministry. I see you riding a horse, and the horse is being led by the Lord. Now, whenever you see any kind of a vehicle, usually in a vision or a dream or whatever from the Lord, when you see a vehicle, even a horse. Of course, there's individual meanings. Like if you saw someone driving a great big giant bus versus someone driving a motorcycle, you could assume or you could infer that the bus is a big ministry and then the motorcycle is a small ministry, but a fast ministry, an agile fast ministry, you know, versus a bus is slow but big. So I saw you on a horse. So, you know, I didn't sit around and think about exactly what that might mean as a type of ministry, but it is a type of ministry, a horse led by the Lord. So I guess it would be old-fashioned type ministry, not a current modern style of ministry, but an old-fashioned style of ministry. As the Lord has just prompted me on that, and it's being led by the Lord himself, Sister Charlene. I hope you guys are getting some teaching out of this. I keep going with my video, but I think it's pretty good teaching. And I know, see, God's outside space and time. Since I asked you guys to pray a few minutes ago about this person, I mean, I can already feel a breakthrough, and you guys haven't even seen the video yet. But God is outside space and time. And I know that people prayed, and I got the breakthrough in Jesus' name, that this person will stop it in Jesus' name. Right now, I've got Mary J. Mary J. Not Mary J. Blige, I guess. Mary J. Father, right now, in the name of Jesus Christ, we pray for Mary J., Lord. We just speak victory right now. I speak, and the Lord has given me the song, May the Circle Be Unbroken. You know, there's an old song, May the Circle Be Unbroken. By and by, Lord, by and by. There's a better home awaiting in the sky, Lord, in the sky. Let the circle not be broken. It's talking about your family, that your whole family be saved. That's probably what you've been asking the Lord and praying about. Seeking ye shall find. The Lord will answer your prayers. The Lord will bless you. The Lord will make a way. He's heard your words. May the circle be unbroken in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Clint D. Clint D. Father, right now in the name of Jesus, we pray for Clint. We pray for Clint in Jesus' name. Father, we declare, hallelujah, hallelujah. And that is here, you shall live and not die, but declare the works of the Lord. And I hear tabernacle in the wilderness for you, Clint. So I guess you're in the wilderness, you're in the desert, but you're praising the Lord. That's what it means to me. And you'll not die, but you're going to live and declare the works of the Lord. Clint D. Andre. Right now we pray for Brother Andre in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. 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 Thank you, Father, in Jesus' name. I hear the word draft. I hear the word draft for you, Andre. Maybe you've made a draft of something you want to make a video about, but you haven't done it, maybe, or a book, or I don't know, a letter you've drafted. Father, right now we pray for Brother Andre. And I hear the word self-sacrifice. I hear the word self-sacrifice for you too, Andre. Hallelujah, Father, we give you the praise and the glory in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. And I hear thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven for you too, Brother Andre, in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. And I hear lap, L-A-P-E. Now, I don't know if it's like lap, running a lap, or lap like a dog laps water. I mean, I don't know, L-A-P, lap. Sitting on somebody's lap. There's lots of English words, right? There's multiple meanings, but I hear the word lap. April W. Father, right now, in the name of Jesus, Lord, we declare victory for Sister April W. Hallelujah, Lord, we just pray for Sister April W. right now, in Jesus' name. Hallelujah, Father, we declare victory right now for Sister April in Jesus' name. Lord, I thank you, Lord God, for, Lord, that even people, I hear the word say about a speck, like someone has a speck in their eye, and judging other people that have a big, someone's got a speck in their eye, and then we judge them when we got a big stick sticking out of our eye. I heard that, Sister April W. It's been about, judging other people when we also are full of sin is something I heard from the Lord, that maybe somebody's doing it to you or vice versa. I don't know. I hear that the Lord's grace is enough. The Lord's grace is enough. Hallelujah, Father, we give you the praise and the glory right now, Father. We honor you. We praise you, Lord. It's whisperers and backbiters, April. I hear that. Whisperers and backbiters. So someone must be doing it to you, who's whispering and backbiting you, and then, they got a stick in their eye and they're talking about the speck in your eye. Sister April, of course, we have to ignore those people because the Lord is our judge, right? No one else is our judge. But now when, like me, our people are preaching, I'm preaching, boom, it's for everybody. And then what I would say from the Lord that would convict people of sin, yourself or whoever, then it would convict you for repentance. And that's different than judging people. And someone's whispers and backbiters against you, sister. And I declare God give you the victory over that, and God wants you to ignore it, of course. And move away. I hear the word Lord say, move away. Move away, Sister April W., right now in Jesus' name. Matthew. We pray for Matthew right now in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. And, of course, Matthew means gift of God. And the Lord said, you are a gift of God indeed. Righteousness exalts a nation. Brother Matthew, that's the word of the Lord for you. Righteousness exalts a nation, and you are a gift of God, and you are a gift of God indeed, the Lord says. Teresa, Father, right now, in the name of Jesus Christ, the Son of the living God, we just pray for Teresa. Sister Teresa, we speak right now your blessings. United we stand, and divided we fall, is the word I heard from you for you, Sister Teresa. United we stand, divided we fall. That's the word for you. Judy, Sister Judy, also from the Northwest, far, far Northwest. Sister Judy, right now, in the name of Jesus Christ, Father, I just speak your blessings right now. We come in agreement, Lord, and speak your blessings on Sister Judy. We speak, Lord God, your grace, your mercy, your peace, your righteousness upon Sister Judy, Lord God. Hallelujah. Father, we thank you. We magnify your name. I speak your loving kindness upon her, and I see holy angels surrounding you, Sister Judy. I see holy angels. Hallelujah. And I just hear that, you know, you'll mount up on wings of eagles. She'll run and not grow weary. She'll, you know, whatever it says, walk and not fail. That's from Isaiah. Those who wait on the Lord will renew their strength. I can't get my mind right to say the exact quote. And I'm trying to remember the chapter. I think it's Isaiah 47. I could be wrong. Sister Judy, forgive me for not remembering the exact chapter. But you can search it in eSword or even Google it, you know. Those who wait on the Lord will renew their strength. That's the Bible verses for the Lord, for you. And the Lord has said you're surrounded. You're surrounded by wings of eagle, of the eagle. That's the Lord is the eagle. The Lord is another way of the Lord. You know, there's the four cherubim that are going around the throne of God, and they have face of an eagle, face of a man, face of an ox, and the face of a lion. And these things all represent different things about Christ. Of course, the eagle representing the prophetic view. You know, the eagle flies high and he can see. And that's what the Lord is saying to you, Sister Judy, about a prophetic ministry, prophetic, that you would have prophetic vision in Jesus' name. The eagle represents the prophet in the you know, the what people call about the fivefold ministry. There's the fourfold ministry, really, because pastor, teacher, really, in the Greek, they go together. Pastor, teacher is one thing, really. So there's really a fourfold ministry. But anyway, each of those ministries represents, you know, Christ had all the ministry, and then maybe the apostles had really all. And then, you know, this divided up, you got your apostles, the modern day apostles, and then not like the ones that wrote the Bible, but sent ones. Apostle means sent one. So you have your modern day, really, you could call them apostles. Really, missionaries are doing the job of an apostle, going into a new area, establishing the church, building up the body of Christ, raising up leaders, elders, pastors, building the churches, establishing the church in an unreached area. That's really a sent one, a modern day apostle, not the same as the apostles from the Bible, the 12 and all that, and Paul. Anyway, that's what we call them today, really, missionaries. And then that's part of what an apostle does. They have this authority and power of signs and wonders in the church too that, you know, most people don't have. Anyway, so the apostle is really represented by the lion. That authority, as Jesus says, the lion of the tribe of Judah, his authority goes out. You know, he divides his authority among these four different ministries. And so apostle really represents the lion. So, and then the eagle is, as I got on this topic, the eagle, the prophet. You know, you can fly and see high up above other people. You can see outside, you know, space and time. The ox, of course, is the pastor. You know, he serves and labors a labor of love for the body of Christ. He's a servant to the body of Christ as a pastor. And then evangelist is a man. God represents himself as a human in the flesh, just like everybody else. He goes out in the world and presents himself as a man to the world, because that's all they can relate to. And then they can know the Lord as the lion. Then they can know the Lord as the, you know, through prophetically, like the eagle. And so, just like there's a brother, Darren, as I mentioned, who's going to be doing for the new people, you know, the evangelistic part of the Church of the Firstborn. You know, he can mingle among, you know, people that do evangelism and get into that. They can mingle among the lost and present themselves as a human to people, talk in human terms, non-Christian lingo. You know, God presents himself as a man through people, you know, and then as a lion with that authority of an apostle, and so on, as I've been saying. If you're watching this, you get some good information. I'm up to 48 minutes. I don't want to stop. I'm trying to mark this list. I'm going to finish this page so I can, you know, stop carrying it around. Start on my list. Number 6 or number 5. All right, I got a few more. Sue, Sister Sue, right now in the name of Jesus, Father, we pray for Sister Sue. Father, we give you the praise and glory in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, Father, we give you the praise and glory. And I hear sweet wine for you, Sister Sue, and wine representing the Holy Spirit. Sweet wine for Sister Sue in the name of Jesus. Lord would give you, you know, a new wine, fill you with His Spirit. Sweet wine is also new wine, that the Lord would fill you with His Holy Spirit. I mean, you've been seeking that, or the Lord wants you to seek that, to be filled with His Holy Spirit. I got to stop, brothers and sisters. That's all I can do. that's all I can do today, brothers and sisters. I'm already at 50 minutes. God bless you guys. You know I love you guys. And I'll be back in Bakersfield tomorrow and get this loaded. It should be Thursday. I think it's March the 6th. God bless you guys. Love you. And pray for me, and I'll pray for you. God bless you guys.